It would have been curtains for Shea Hope if that had hit.
Yeah, just to finish what his efforts have done, he broke into the West Indies T20 international team recently against India. Scored 45 and 29 in that 40-20i, then an unbeaten 22 to win for the West Indies. That was in the 50-20i. So with every T20 game, he's growing in stature in this format of the game. He's already established himself in ODI cricket as one of the leading batters in world cricket.
And one of the few all-format players now for West Indies. I think it just goes into international men's cricket, where everyone now is drawn to the basketball part of things. That there are sometimes you may need to be playing a bit more aggressive, even though it's a test or it's a one-day international. So good on him to see the need for that adjustment in his career.
Another dot to end the over. Very good one from Kyle Mayers. Only two runs coming from it after 5.33 for one.
For one, the Guyana Amazon Warriors big over number four. 12 runs coming from it. Jason Holder now into the attack in this match number 23 of the Republic Bank Men's CPL. This is the business end, my friends. Really important at this stage for momentum and for points. Morning to all of you. Morning to Ian Bishop.
Morning, Alex. Hello, everyone. All of these contests so very important for the teams with different reasons, with not a flying start for the Amazon Warriors, but they're building a foundation. More important for the Barbados Royals, given where they are on the table right now, 2 points would catapult them above the St. Lucia Kings. But that will have to be hard-earned because the Warriors have been playing brilliantly.
They have been outstanding. They've been distinguishing themselves in all aspects of the game, the Guyana Amazon Warriors. And perhaps a testament to that is that this team is in a good position. They're comfortable. They can make a change. Giving a chance. And a little tryout to Gudakesh Modi at the top. Didn't work. Let's move on. Early out fans inside this Brian Lara Cricket Academy. The support for this CPL so incredible here in Taruba. They've got a triple header to look forward to today. This is match one. Atezo insight for you early in the morning. Have a look at that. Jason Holder, leading wicket taker this season. 12 wickets to his name. No one else from either of these two teams on that top five. And he's showing his worth here immediately, Holder. Four dots on the trot. Last couple balls of this Sky Fair power play. Just keeping the Warriors quiet for the minute.
Stay on him there, boys. Stay on him.
Ayub, big and big enough. Well, he got one away, didn't he? And it was a full maximum. A Republic Bank six to end the over. Oh, one ball to go.
It is a brave shot because there's a deep square in the mid-wicket, but hitting with the wind, that has gone straight over the head of Roelof van den Merwe there at mid-wicket. First boundary that Ayub has hit, and that is saying something in the power play for someone so aggressive.
Good running. Six gone. The end of the Sky Fair power play. The Warriors are 41 for one. The Guyana Amazon Warriors. That is their Sky Fair power play score. Leslie Rifa will give us the signal, closing out the power play. So fielding restrictions loosened. More men outside the circle. This man, Shea Hope, is in such good nick. So quick between the wickets, so fit, so focused and disciplined. Darren Ganga mentioned he's upping his strike rate. He offers so much to a side. Both these batters, though, have not gone as quickly as they would have liked in these first six. How can they go on from here? Ian Bishop. Talk us through this power play.
It's a power play that built a foundation with Moti coming in at the top of the innings, hitting a six, then being dismissed. So they're trying that Sunil Narine thing with Moti at the top, with Chandrapal Hemraj lacking form. But it's been a steady acceleration, and that six to close out the power play would have done them the world of good. It just took them past their lowest power play score of the season with that boundary. But it's building a foundation with Mears into his fourth over, which can sometimes be a risk, but he'll be hoping this last one outside of the power play, he can close it out with the extra protection with five fielders on the boundary. Get his overs out of the way. If he gets a wicket, all the better. I want to come back to a point about the dimensions. And simply this, Alex. You saw that six off Jason Holder. It's not that a batter cannot be dismissed caught on the boundary on that western side of the ground. It's a terrific shot, but you want to stop them from hitting on that side and force them to try to hit sixes into the wind on the other side. So that definitely will be a factor as we go through this game and through the day.
Oh, it's put down. A straightforward catch. Obed McCoy cannot believe it, and neither can Kyle Mears. Opportunity for the Barbados Royals goes a-begging.
That should have been taken. It was the wicket that Mears would have been searching for in his final over. Obed moving to his favorite side, his left side, with that reverse cup sort of thing, because of the trajectory of the ball, should have pocketed it.
Oh, lovely. Lofted into the outside. This is often what happens after a missed chance. Saeem Ayub with a graceful Republic Bank six.
Bringing up the 50 as well for the Amazon Warriors. back of the hand went wrong, dragged it down too short, and that's into the wind. So if you want them to hit sixes, let them take the chance over there. But are you too strong, too powerful? But you've got to take these sorts of catches because this is the end result. Not saying that if Saim Ayoub that was dropped, but Mears would have had a wicket.
No! Saim!
So with that sort of reverse cup, it hit, I think, to the heel, the bottom of the left hand. Didn't absorb it. And so Shehope, remember this was on 15. So let's see what the cost is to that.
Just a single off the final ball of the over. 12 from it. Warriors 53 for one.
A decent enough outing by Kyle Mears with a new ball, four overs on the trot for 24. He should have had a wicket, should have had the wicket of hope. But an economical spell anyway. Leaving.
Well, just the one wicket for Rakeem Cornwall. Perhaps Kyle Mears should have had one too. Going off. Have to keep abreast of that situation, see if he's all right. And the man who dropped the catch, Obed McCoy, now has the opportunity to make amends. Best of one for 37 in his seven matches. Not in his best form, but we know his capabilities. Ian Bishop, you mentioned the power play built a foundation here, but Ayoub currently going at 116, Hope going at 106. Is it enough? Is it quick enough?
They would have wanted to be quicker, but let's see. Barbados Royals have bowled well to them. We're not giving enough credit in the power play for Barbados Royals. We talk about Hope and we talk about Ayoub and how destructive they can be. The fact is they haven't been let off the hook in the power play. Now, because they're still there, Ayoub was 9 from 13 when he scored that half century against TKR at the Oval. 9 from 13 in the power play and accelerated outside. It could get two here. Something that Shehope and Ayoub do well, as you heard from Darren Ganga. So I think it's in the balance right now. It was almost the lowest power play Amazon Warriors had this year. Now, what we saw from Patriots yesterday was that they bowled so well, they managed to restrict the Kings to a chaseable total. With the depth in this Guyana Amazon Warriors, it won't be that easy. Great power hitting depth.
You're right there. All departments covered for the Warriors. But like you say, credit to the Royals and their attack thus far.
And just let me stress that it's only credit thus far, because this power balance of power could shift at any point.
Spoken like the true taskmaster you are, Ian Bishop. We're not getting ahead of ourselves, folks, in this match 23. This is the glorious thing about this, the shortest format of the game. So many battles within battles. The Omega Skycam XL about to take off. We are ready to take flight. Wonderful, wonderful images they've been giving us all tournament long. Here we are in the south of Trinidad, Taruba. South of central Trinidad, maybe just north of San Fernando. Here's a candidate for the fan of the match. CPL fan of the match, you can win yourself some money. TCL voucher for 500 US. How about it? I remind all those in Guyana, We are coming there tomorrow. This week will be the Guyana leg of the Republic Bank Men's CPL, so you get your costumes ready.
Keen to see where Robman Powell goes from a bowling perspective from the other end now that Carl Mayers has finished his four over quarter. Jason Holder has bowled a solitary over. He's got Carlos Brathwaite back in the team. Went for a ton, 66, I think, in his only game of the tournament so far.
Oh, well, he's just teeing off here, Saeem Ayoub. That one into the party stand. And Rex, what was a decent over for Obed McCoy. 13 from it, 8 gone. Warriors are 66 for 1. It's a solid partnership between Saeem Ayoub and Shea Hope. 57 off just 41 balls here. Having lost Gudakesh Moti early. And Ian Bishop, what we're noticing here, bowlers not finishing their over as well. You talked about praising this Royals attack. Didn't want to show your hand too early. Holder, a 6-4 off the last two balls of the sixth. And just there, Obed McCoy, 6 off the last ball.
It's a good shot again, but it's hit with the wind. It came in with the angle from about off stump, so it's a top shot. Now, Kais Ahmed. We'll find out now how amenable this surface is to spin. And I apologize if in the last over I confused everyone. When that six was hit, Shehope was dropped. I knew Shehope was dropped. Had that catch been taken, the strike would not have been turned over. So that's the point I was trying to make. Anyway, that's gone. This is now.
If you're watching in the Caribbean, it's probably a little early. Ian Bishop, he's really quick. It's a brain that works fast. Wow, a bit like that ball. Out of here. Kais Ahmed, out the park, first ball. Shea Hope looking lovely. Seems to have impressed himself.
After the foundation that was set with two batters getting in, now starting to muscle the ball for Republic Bank maximums. And with the depth in batting that they have, it is a situation where they need to shift gear and shift tempo. You don't want to leave all those power hitting resources in the pavilion at the end of your innings. And again, that's hit with the wind. The tactic has to be to try to make them hit to the other side, the eastern side. There's our cameraman. Marius, get back to work.
So many skills. Writes the theme tune, sings the theme tune, playing for a team. Well done, Marius. Oh, Trinidad and Tobago is a stunning place. It not only looks beautiful, it feels just gorgeous, because it's a place where you get such a rich and deep sense of the people. Their spirits soar. They're fun to be around, the Trinis. You talked about the player depth the Guyana Amazon Warriors have, Ian Bishop. And the Barbados Royals will be thinking about that. And on top of that, Saeem Ayoub in the power play goes at 118. In the middle overs, at 197.
A free-spirited player.
It's just fun for the whole family, the Republic Bank CPL. Oh, look at the face paint. I hope they're staying in there for the next match, which will be the Massey Women CPL final. Super excited for that. Same matchup.
Out. Out, Kate. go, let's go.
Nine from the over so far, two still to face. To bowl rather, go, pressure on Case Ahmed here to try and finish strong.
The Amazon Warriors have been superb against spin this season. We were talking about that in the pre-show. The seamers of the Royals, the most expensive so far this season, going at over 10s. The Warriors, the best team, averaging 66.5 against spin. So that's the conundrum for the Royals against this team.
Yeah, as we noticed, the Royals at the bottom of that list. 77 for one. Angus Chora, chill, refreshing moment for these Guyana Amazon Warriors fans. And why not? The team have given them a good start. Set themselves up here for a decent total. Carlos Brathwaite back into the 11 today and into the attack. Best of four for 15. Now, despite a slower start than they would have liked, they've set themselves up over 200 runs if they go at 12s. At 10s, 185, decent score. And Amazon Warriors won the toss, put themselves into bat. So far, this top order has rewarded them for the decision. Good morning to all of you from the beautiful Caribbean. Wonderful to be back at Brian Lara. We had a triple header yesterday and another one today. This is the first match. It's hot and steamy. Not a cloud in the sky, as they say. Looks like we'll have wonderful weather. We've been lucky here in Trinidad so far. Long may it last. Lots of important matches today.
Yeah, from above there and now from almost at ground level, that right-hand side of your screen has a deep point, deep extra cover. So Brathwaite is going to try to stay outside of stump. And he does stay outside of stump, and it goes straight to that deep point that was pushed back. That's what we're talking about, making the batters, certainly the left-handed Ayoub, score on the eastern side. If he wants to score on the west, make him fetch the ball from outside the off-stump. He's a wonderful player, but these are the little tactics you have to use on this surface. I suppose, conversely, if you're Carlos Brathwaite and you're looking to bowl straight to Shea Hope, who's now off strike, perhaps you don't want Cornwall at short fine leg. You want a more mobile, and I'm not being terrible, a more mobile fielder at short fine leg if you're bowling straight, because the ball tends to get clipped around there.
Well fielded. Good bet bar to super save in the deep. That's Case Ahmed backing up Carlos Brathwaite. Good morning to you. If you're having your breakfast around the Caribbean, great to have you with us. Download the Sportsmax app. You can watch the CPL anywhere, anytime in the Caribbean region. If you're in the kitchen, if you're still in bed, if you're in the living room, have friends over. If you're on the go, you could be out on the water and still catching the biggest party in sport. with that Sportsmax app.
One run short there. Or maybe they want to check it. The umpire did signal. It must be a new thing. It's the second time in the tournament we've seen the umpire signal one short, and it meant they're checking it. So it's not confirmed at the bowler's end. So it's Ayub going up there and touching down. Not getting across there. Does he get across there? All the best to the television umpire.
Yes, Bish. Looks like, yeah, looks like he just got over the line. So that's fine. Not one short. Five runs off it, one to go.
And it also means with Braffitt, he tried to come tight at the off stump to try to bring other dismissals into play. Occasionally. But that's again across him and wide of off stump.
We're at the halfway mark here. The Guyana Amazon Warriors, 83 for one. And it's time for the Angostura chill break. Let's have a drink.
As per, with 10 overs done, players and the officials out in the centre having a nice little refreshment. Ayub 36, Hope 32, not out. In terms of the highlights of this innings so far, Moti sent in as a pinch hitter, six and out. Skied one there, all very comfortable for Obed McCoy. This partnership between these two, Ayub and Hope, has started to get underway. And you've got to take those. Now, that could be a bit of a game changer. Got to take those catches, Obed McCoy. And instead, it's allowed Ayub and Hope to put on 74 and 53. And Kyle Mears getting very aggrieved. Dozen dot balls in his 24, he'll probably take that, but he would love the wicket or two. Cornwall is the only successful bowler to date. And McCoy, he started expensively again. Case Armour disappeared out of the ballpark very first one. And Brathwaite, just the one over as well, to make the run rate at the moment. The run rate is 8.3. And we're going to have Roelof van der Merwe into the attack, and we're going to have Samuel Badry. Spin, spin, and more spin everywhere.
Hello, Danny. Hello, everyone. Yes, that has been the theme here at the Brian Lara Cricket Academy. Didn't see Roelof in that last game against the Knight Riders at the Queen's Park Oval. We're seeing him here today. Left-handed Saim Ayub on strike. So a negative matchup for Roelof. But this time, Powell decides to utilize him. It takes him on immediately, finds the gap. Two fielders in the deep there. Actually, three on the leg side for Van der Merwe. But Ayub, with pinpoint precision, gets the boundary.
Yeah, there's a couple of fielders there for that sort of straight slog sweep, as it were. Bisected them beautifully with the timing and a nice precision with the bat. He's trying to run this. Oh, yeah, look, he's had negative matchups. We said this and mentioned it last night. And Stacey King was all over it in terms of wanting Ahmad Wasim to come on. And did so. So it doesn't really matter, yes, I think, in these situations. Yes, you've got a bit of spin on offer, variety.
One pass, one air roll.
And as ever, Sayyub is such an onside player. 84% of his strokes, and there confirms it. He's trying to go through the offside, and he hasn't had much joy in the last three deliveries. That he's such a leg side player. 84% versus 16. What a stat.
Yeah, that information, no doubt, would be known by the opposition players by now. And so look to force him to score offside. That line in that direction, but too easy for Saim Ayub. Too full, allows him to free his arm. A Republic Bank maximum from the diminutive Saim.
Well, you've got to be quite precise with that, because you've got Jason Holder, all 6'8" of him, in that hot spot. But it cleared him comfortably. 74, 75 metres in that pocket. And he got enough willow on it. Handsome stroke over long on. Last one, 10 off. Oh, Roelof, don't get in there, brother. He has disappeared with back-to-back sixes. 50 up for Ayub. Wonderful hand, and he is such a little pocket rocket.
Yeah, the diminutive dynamo that is Saim Ayub. Consecutive half centuries for him, 62 against the Trinbago Knight Riders at the Queen's Park Oval, unbeaten 52 here. Just too straight and too easy, too short down the leg side, always asking for trouble. 16 runs from that Van der Merwe over. Saim Ayub has really impressed me throughout the CPL. Really good acquisition for the Guyana Amazon Warriors. He's delivered. We're heading towards the business end of the tournament, Danny Morrison. Amazon Warriors heading to Guyana for their home matches and then the playoffs. Really exciting times ahead. Carlos Brathwaite to continue.
Hope. Yeah. He's looking solid as well. 100 is up for one for the Warriors. It's time to catch up with Naomi Cowan.
Danny, so of course, the Warriors just hit 100. So I'm with a family of Warriors that is celebrating. I'm with Christopher, Leah, and Christian. Show them your shirts. They have customized family shirts. I'm obsessed. So cute. So Christopher, what I love about this moment here, it just shows the generational power of cricket.
Yes, it is.
I mean, you brought your kids out, you have your customized shirt for the Warriors, but also for the game. How long have you been watching and falling in love with this sport?
Oh, since I was a kid, I'm in love with cricket. You know, cricket has always been the game of our sport of choice. So yeah, since I'm a kid, we were watching cricket. I'm just here, you know, bring out the kids so they will eventually grow into it, you know, because cricket is a unifying game, as you can speak, so yeah.
My goodness, and we will be in Guyana for the finals. Are you joining us?
Yes, I'll be there, definitely on the 24th, yeah.
Oh my gosh, so Leah, do you love cricket?
Yes, this is my first time being to cricket.
This is your very first time? How lucky am I? What's your favorite thing about the sport? What do you love the most, the sixes? Do you love the bowling? Do you love the crowd?
I love the bowling.
The bowling. So we have a future bowler on our hands. And Christian, do you play cricket right now in school?
No, I was normally playing football, but I'm out of it right now because while I was playing, sometime I fractured my hand.
Okay, so you fractured your hand. So you're a real sportsman. So before I send it up to the comms box, Christian. Oh, we just had another big one from the Warriors. So say something to the Warriors in celebration of that last ball.
Congratulations! We believe in you!
That's it. Back to you guys in the comms box.
Yeah. Thank you, Naomi. Branthwaite getting a little too straight there. And, of course, that is going with the breeze from east to west. Look at that western terrace, as it were. Just wonder with Big Carlos, some very good cutters, pace off, bravery, but get it to grip maybe. And he's taken it, has he? Yes, he has. I thought it carried. Wonderful stuff. Try to improvise here did Ayub and get across his off stump. Creamery novelty sweep play by Ricky. Don't lose that number, Brathwaite.
Yeah, very expensive in the last game that he played, Carlos Brathwaite. You can see that early movement. You can see Carlos Brathwaite going even wider. And a dolly of a return. Lots of antics at the end from Carlos Brathwaite. A wicket for him finally. Saim Ayub goes for a very well played 58, 107 for two.
Azim Khan strides out to the centre. He's 25 years young, son of Moen Khan, World Cup winning wicketkeeper back then, that 92 edition. Strike rate sensational. Yeah, just held it back slightly, seam up, not a cut or anything, but yeah, big tumble roll and everything. Careful, big guy. There's a lot of you, Carlos. The Guardian Life happiness moment to Carlos Brathwaite with a nice little caught and bowled. Gets a wicket. Now then, the powerful figure of Azim Khan up against Brathwaite. Yeah, good lines from Big Ricky B.
Yeah, they have lots of power, lots of depth in this batting lineup, the Guyana Amazon Warriors. Azim Khan showed some of his quality, unbeaten 29 from 14 at the Queen's Park Oval. Het Meyer, no need to talk about him and his power. Pretorius, Shepherd, Kimo Paul, Odin Smith, all can give it a whack. Dot the end. Very good platform lead. 12 gone, 107 for two.
Let's go, boy. 10.
Carlos Ricardo Brathwaite, 1 for 14. Now he's feeling better about life, hence the nickname. It's Ricky that you often see on his shirt. But the fans for another tall individual. 6'8", Jason Holder. There's another tall individual. Obed McCaw. McCaw has got to get some rhythm here, get some confidence. Starts with a slow Yorker, full one, outside off pole. Laurie Evans, old Loz is the man with the gloves on, with a balance to the side, just changing somewhat. So interesting to see what both sides have done. You had Moti coming and open. Now you've got Laurie Evans, gloves and sunglasses on. Keeping in the side today with no Rivaldo Clark. And Obed, yeah, desperately needs to get in a bit of confidence and a groove.
Yeah, we've spoken about the fluctuating season that they're having, the Barbados Royals, that is. They've lost, they've won, they've lost, they've won, and so on. So it's been a roller coaster tournament for them. Rahman Powered sell at the toss that even though they're not playing the best cricket, they're still in with a chance of qualifying for the playoffs. So it is heartening from that standpoint, I suppose, if they can click, if they can get a total game together. Wide outside off stump. He reckons that they can challenge any team in this tournament. When they've been good, they've been really good. They chased down 220 at the Kensington Oval quite easily, overs to spare. But when they've been bad, they've been woeful. And that's what you don't want. You want to be level. You want to be consistent with your performances. You want to be competing every game. Up, down, up, down. Trevor Penny himself mentioned it in a pre-match interview. They're striving to be better every game.
Yeah, good point, Sammy. Also, Trevor mentioned that, yeah, trying to get all the different facets of the game right. They're fielding, they're catching, they're batting, and they're bowling, and all those different departments has been so inconsistent. Trying to stitch sort of seven or eight guys doing it in a particular match rather than relying on just two or three guys to get you over the line. That's what they've got to sort out to the Royals. On the other hand, they're up against the most consistent side. Haven't lost a game, but they're up there with TKR. They win this, they go top of the tree.
Yeah, just a couple of things I want to mention, Danny. Obed McCoy has been very expensive this season. He's been going over tens and over. He's only picked up one wicket in all of the matches that he's played. So from that standpoint, it puts the Barbados Royals under tremendous pressure. He's one of their wicket-taking bowlers, or at least someone they've identified to be penetrative for them. That hasn't transpired, and so they've been under pressure. The other thing is, I'm looking at Shehop, 34 of 30 deliveries.
Now then, hasn't got enough of it. Gone! Danger man! Obed McCoy can give us a little bit of an El Dorado celebration. And just chatting up here with Samuel B about trying to get some confidence, Obed McCoy, this will go a long, long way.
Yeah, as you can see, they're only his second wicket this season. This went very, very high in the sky. Usually it will sail over the boundary. The wind perhaps wasn't as strong. Good catch, yes. That is what it means to McCoy. He's been struggling. Doc Dredd is here. North for Azam Khan, north from 4, 109 for 3.
Azam Khan in and out. Time for a powerful left-hander that is Shimran Hetmeyer. He too in his mid-20s. Good numbers. Interesting. Just that higher score versus the Tulawars of 60. So he often does come in at five or six at times and finish off the innings. Coming in finish things off. Perhaps between 14 to 20. But this will feel really good. A little cutter, perhaps, there from Obed. I think it was a little bit of pace off. And he was very tempted, was Azim Khan, going with the wind. He's hitting to that side there on that western terrace and thought, yep, I'm taking it on, and came second. Greaves with a good reverse cut. Now, pleased for you, Obed. It can be a cruel game. If you're slightly off with your skill, that is, your bowling, your rhythm might not be clicking there. It's not coming out as well. You're feeling a bit frustrated and awkward at the bowling crease. And you go short early. I like it. Test out to hit my first up. 13 done. It's 110 for three. Come on, then. Just over nines a little while ago. That was because Sayem Ayoob was in and going nicely with Shea Hope. And now Ayoob's gone, and so is Azim Khan. So the Pakistani connection's gone. They're just a little bit down. Yeah, they're a minute behind there on the innings timer. Time for big Jace Holder. The far end of Lara. Oh, beautiful. Beautiful line and length. Holder thought he heard something. Very excited. But just a bit of fresh air through to Laurie Evans.
It might just be bat passing close to the surface, making contact with the pitch. Don't think there's any edge there. Jason Holder, as bowlers usually are, always animated. Another play and a miss. Good start from Holder. Yeah, I was just talking about Shea Hope and his 34 from 30. It's just over a runner ball, and you never know, Danny Morrison, until the game is over, how good this knock is or how disappointing it is. But I understand what they're trying to do because of the slowness of the surface, give themselves a good platform. Just a single because of the power and the depth that they have, but they'll need to get a move on to get upwards of 160, 170 in this innings.
Yeah, it's always been a bit of a talking point, that, isn't it, with Shea Hope in particular, given that he's not really a boundary hitter, a six hitter, I mean. He's more of a stroke maker, and of course we know about Test cricket and 50 over stuff. One of those 100 in each innings at Headingley. West Indies got up in a test match. Extraordinary. Here is Nelson, though. Beware, all you superstitious types. And all the H's, yes. I've been enlightened. Holder to Hope and Hetmeyer. It's all happening with the three ones as well. Yes, he did play and miss. Says Ultra Edge, but you're right, Sammy B. Us pace bowlers just like to let the umpire know that we're around and clearing the lungs. Another good delivery. Well, Obed with a big batter super save. Good stuff, big fella.
Yeah, that would have been at least two, if not three, possibly even four. There's no protection behind him if he missed that. So good work from the big quick. That's the sort of desperation and support that you need in the field. These 2 points more crucial for the Royals than they are for the Amazon Warriors.
Oh, is that carry? Rodman Powell is such a good fielder, and he is in a lot of trouble, actually. His fingers, with it crunched and squeezed it there. We've had 14, 113 for three.
1 minute down.
Rather up and down affair here with the Warriors, really getting into the overdrive, but for long enough. Just a couple of wickets of late have stymied things somewhat for the Warriors. Now this one is catched, full-blooded slap into the covers from Hetmeyer. Just on the half volley there, maybe here we go, here's a better angle. Oh, it's right at the end of the fingertips. I think it did carry. Maybe another angle, gents. But yeah, that's crunched those fingers. He's got a bit of tape on them, as Rodman Powell. So that'll be smarting someone. Here's Case Armour. He's only bowled one that went for 11 up against Hetmeyer. It's been a little short this morning, I have to say.
Yeah, I think that opportunity for Rothman Powell in the last over, Danny Morrison, has to go down as a drop catch based on what we saw last night from Fabian Allen. That was an absolute blinder. We know that he's sensational in the field. Yeah, just getting a bit of spray on the fingertips. Yeah, that's where your sensory neurons are, just at the tips of the fingers. So whenever there's a blow there, it will hit. Talking about that catch, have a look at this, folks. That's a one-hander. He's left-handed. This is towards Rothman Powell. I think he stood on the triangle. Yeah, he knows it. You can tell from his body language. That's a miss. Not entirely sure perhaps where the boundary rope is behind him, and he makes contact. So six for Shea Hope, another one in the innings, Danny.
Well, there's an example of the skipper being concerned about his fingers and niggling little injury, and he was having some attention down there. But yeah, that's frustrating for the Royals, let alone the bowler Case Armour. Now straight as, and six more. Republic Banker for sixer, back to back of them from Shea Hope.
Yeah, got a lot more of it this time. No help from the fielder needed. Consecutive sixes. His strike rate has now shot up to over 130, 134. So he's decided that it's time for him to get a move on. 47 from 35 now.
Yeah, Hope. He's cussing himself there. He thinks he's missed out. Yeah, I was just thinking about Case Armour with his length. Just a tad short. And then when he has given it some air, just been a little bit slot. So he's just fractionally off this morning as the Afghan. So this over's gone for 14. He's bowled almost two. One to go, one delivery to go, that is. He's gone for 25. Gonna come around here up against Hetmeyer. And he goes large and fetch this big. Yes. Three sixes in the over, 20 off the 15th, and the Warriors are 133 for three.
good over for the Guyana Amazon Warriors. The numbers tell you how well they play spin this season. K. Samet 2 for 31, Van der Merwen 1 for 16, that's overs. Carlos Brathwaite. Just a little behind time, the Royals, but Stacey Ann King, a very, very good over that last one for GAW.
Yeah, 20 runs coming from that over. Yeah, this is exactly how you want to be scoring in this final phase.
Carlos Brathwaite has brought up that deep third. One of the things that you're planning, and I was talking about Saim Ayub, that's leg stump, that's hitting with the wind. So we talked about that earlier, and Brathwaite then pushed it wider, asked him to fetch it from outside off stump into the wind, or with the wind, I should say, bringing the wicket. It's a simple plan. The fact that he's going on that same line to Hetmyer without the deep third or deep backward point is interesting. So we talked about that in the build-up. Make them hit into the wind or fetch it from wide outside off stump. Brathwaite has done that quite well so far to the left-handers. The other one that I want to look at, which was from the opposite end, was Obed McCoy bowling to Azam Khan. It's the angle, it's a little close to off stump, but Azam has to fetch it because he wants to hit with the wind. That has to be a priority. I thought Saim Ayub was allowed to hit with that wind a lot. He also scored into the wind, so give him great credit, Saim Ayub.
Yeah, when I look at that Azam Khan dismissal, that delivery was much straighter as well. Don't think he had that width to get under it, hence the reason holding out in the deep. But this has been really good from Shea Hope, 49 from 37. Brings up the 50. His 50 from 38. Four sixes and 1-4 in this innings so far. Teammates acknowledging his effort. Yeah, sixth.
Yeah, it's been a steady knock up until that last over where he got a couple of sixes. As Samuel Badri said, time will tell how valuable it is, because it's a pitch I still think that it pays off. You can get some reward on it. 1-3-8 for three.
Yeah, that 15th over, pretty big one, 20 runs coming from it, but hoping to end well.
I didn't miss what Stacey Ann did between overs there. Hoping to end well, pun intended. 1 minute behind the Barbados Royals. And they have to try to get through this over quickly, otherwise they could lose a fielder for the next over. Obed was down. He was floored, Obed McCoy, after delivery there. Is Shea Hope one of your favorite players? You can go to rario.com and buy official CPL player cards. Might it be Siam Ayoub, who played a blistering innings post-power play? Outstanding power hitting, six sixes.
Okay, great innings from Shea Hope, 50 from 39. And four sixes and 1-4.
Chopped on. Apart from that one over, it's been a struggle really for Shea Hope. It's a tough surface. Who knows how significant the innings may be in combination with others, but a second wicket for McCoy. And again, he goes across it.
Yeah, the southpaw strikes. And played on from Shea Hope. But he goes for 50, a well-played 50. 139 for four.
Kimo Paul, with that wonderfully unique hairstyle, a true Amazon warrior, if ever there was one, who's been batting well. He's standing on off stump, I think. That right toe.
Yeah, which is why Obed McCoy opted for a straighter delivery. Yeah, just that initial movement. End of the bat and onto the stumps.
Well, I wonder if Hetmyer would have been safe if that hit the stumps, but that wasn't really as energetic from Obed McCoy. I think he's cramping. We saw him down in that little period, stretching when the wicket fell. Would have been gone.
Yeah, interesting to see that they picked up two runs just right there, again, in his follow-through. Interesting shot from Kimo Paul. Opting to for the option of sweeping the pacer. Yeah, just stretching his legs there, Obed McCoy. Really seems to be cramping up a bit. It's really hot out there. 10 a.m. matches aren't easy ones to play.
That was just a giveaway, really, from Obed McCoy. But very smart from Hetmyer. 147 for four.
And the slowest delivery, back of the arm. Slowest delivery of his over. Had to wait. Hetmyer.
Not great news for Ruffman Powell because they've been a little behind time. And so they have to have one extra fielder in the circle. Only four allowed outside for this over. They're 3 minutes down, so the penalty might run over into the next over as well. Nice from Kimo Paul. He's been smacking the ball wonderfully well this season, and he continues.
And this actually won't help. With the time. Because now you've got to go fetch that ball and get back in. Twelve sixes and four fours hit in this innings thus far.
Deep cover comes back, mid-off goes back to long-off. He needs to be a little bit straighter, I would think, Jason Holder. Yeah, make him hit into the wind leg side. I think it's a tough pitch to score freely. It really is tough if you bowl cutters. No, Jason Holder, but very good from Kimo Paul. Right in the slot. And smacked away as it deserved.
Yeah, just too full. Huh? Almost like a baseball type swing from Kimo Paul. 81 meters. 13 sixes. You can see the intent just to try and get that delivery in particular a bit more mid-wicket to try and get two, to try and get back the strike. Able to pick up one. Hetmyer is on strike. He's 17 from 13. Looking for the second one, Kimo Paul, always looking. The score predictor, 190.
Much better with his line, and that is very untidy, really untidy from the Royals. Well run though by Kimo Paul and Hetmyer. 161 for four. So another penalty will be applied in this over. Only three fielders now allowed outside the circle. Might get a red card in the next over because they're 2 minutes behind still. So a player could be sent off the field. Hetmyer takes advantage of it, even if there was a fielder there. He says, thank you very much.
Yeah, again, the placement, the shorter boundary, that area. Backward of square. Yeah, backs himself to make the connection. And once again, another maximum. Courtesy the bats of Hetmyer. 14 sixes.
Gone this time. Good from Carlos Brathwaite. He really has come back well in this game. Two wickets now for 25 in 3.2 overs. Under pressure. Well bowled.
Yeah, just being aggressive. Slower delivery from Carlos Brathwaite. Miscued. And an easy catch to get his second wicket. Hetmyer goes for 24 from 16. It's 167 for 5.
Mario Shepherd with that strike rate this season, over 250. And extra fielders in the circle. Dropped it. That should have been taken. It really should have been taken, Kyle Mayers. You timed the jump well enough.
Yeah, earlier we saw Shea Hope being put down on 16. Yeah, they've got to do better in the field, in all phases. Akeem Opol just seems to be really busy out there. Always looking for a single, always looking for two. Always trying to get on strike.
As it should be, to be honest, as it should be with everyone. That's the nature of this game. Every delivery is an event. Mid-off goes back to long off. Should be out. K-Samet takes the catch and another one for Carlos Brathwaite. An outstanding return having been left out in the last game.
And contrasting speeds as well for this third delivery. His second delivery at 103 kilometers, this one 130, so much faster, which means that it rushed Romario Shepherd. He totally lost it going across the line. He goes for two, it's 169 for six.
Of the broadest shoulders in the game, Odine Smith.
He came off the toe of the bat, trying to heave it into the leg side. And settled under it and took a comfortable catch.
Coming round the wicket, I wonder if he's going to try to go into the feet, the legs. None to the stumps. This is outstanding. It really is from Carlos Brathwaite. 4 for 27 from his four overs. And remember, for this over, only three fielders outside the circle. Terrific.
Yeah, that off-stump line changing the angle and staying stump to stump. And picks up his fourth wicket, Carlos Brathwaite, with a brilliant delivery. The Doc Tread comes into play. It's 169 for seven.
Carlos Brathwaite probably is saying to himself, all your talk now. That, though, is not a good sign for the Royals. Second red card of a tournament. TKR suffered the ultimate penalty. Now Ruffman Powell's turn. Only 10 fielders allowed on the field. Cornwall is gone to get himself ready to bat. And only two outside the circle. And for all the discussion around this, I have yet to hear any captain who is in agreement. From Brandon King to Pollard to Holder as a player.
Edwin Pretorius, the new batter.
Obed McCoy got berated by Jason Holder for throwing the ball when there was no need.
Yeah, you should be just happy with a single. Yeah, this was the last wicket. Yeah, through the gates. A celebration from Eldorado celebration.
Come on, give it to Talk now. Talk now, everyone. Power failure. Pretorius is gone. Wickets falling towards the back end. Brathwaite first now. Holder. Brathwaite takes an easy catch.
Yeah, you can't keep him out of this game. Carlos Brathwaite. Four wickets. And just a simple catch. Yeah, the Page and Pier of Holder and Brathwaite. Yeah, safe hands. And Pretorius goes without scoring. It's 170 for eight.
Doc Dredd has made significant appearances today. He's becoming a star of the show. Junior Sinclair makes his way to the middle.
Pulled into that leg side where the breeze is blowing across. So would have needed to get a bit more elevation. Yeah, the one change for Guyana Amazon Warriors, Junior Sinclair. And he's in.
Smart thing to do, give Kimo Paul the strike to let him see what he can continue to do. First time Carlos Brathwaite has taken a four-wicket haul in CPL since 2017. Four wickets for four runs, last eight balls. It's still a significant total on the board on the surface. Time will tell the outcome. And still a chance for Paul to add to it. And he does in most magnificent fashion. An all-round player whose talents are starting to mature a little bit more, Kimo Paul.
Yeah, since he got in, he has been in a whole mood, Kimo Paul. trying to get more singles, trying to run harder between the wickets, and able to do just this. Clear boundaries, hit maximums. Two balls to go.
Lights on, hold the strikes again. Five wickets have now fallen in the last 10 deliveries. This is an interesting shift in dynamic, even with a good total on the board.
Get good line. Tried to make room on the leg side. Kimo Paul got his leg stump pegged back. Yeah, good dead bowling here from Jason Holder. Paul goes for 23. 177 for 9.
Kimo Paul's strike rate 230, and that's the importance of those quick fire 20s, etc. The Amazon Warriors captain, Imran Tahir, last man coming in.
Yeah, it's the length for me. Hit for six the previous ball and made the adjustment. Jason Holder.
They were 167 for four. They're now 177 for nine. Still, it's a total on the board with one delivery to go. Much of this has occurred with the limitations of fielders outside the circle. Gets a hand on it, they'll come back for a second. And they'll come back for a third, and they will get a third. Jason Holder is livid. And a fourth. He's absolutely beside himself, Jason Holder, with his colleagues. Yes, he's gone red. The Amazon Warriors finish on 181 for nine. McCoy is down with cramp. Cornwall is off the field. Chaos and carnage in the last five overs. 48 for six of the last five overs of the innings.
And 12 runs coming off that final over, two wickets included. And Captain Powell has gone to ensure that Obi McCoy is okay, that he can come off the field. The physio is also making his way across to him. Well, this has been good from Carlos Brathwaite. Really important spell, 4 for 27. He helped him to have a bat first, and Ghana Amazon Warriors, they'll be pleased with this. 181 for 9. Ayub, 58 from 35. Shea Hope got to another half century from 40. But it's just been really good hitting from this Ghana Amazon Warriors batting lineup.
Ayub was outstanding, 58 from 35, post power play, strike rate just reached a crescendo. That Kimo Paul knock was instructive, and Carlos Brathwaite with 4 for 27 ensured that what could have been so much more, maybe 200, was restricted to 181 for nine, which is still a good total. Let's join Alex Jordan.
Carlos Brathwaite, well, catch your breath. It's hot out there. 4 for 27, your first 4 for in a couple of years. How does it feel?
Yeah, it just feels good to be back on the park. Obviously, wasn't happy with my first outing, I just felt as though I needed to make amends. Obviously, we're still halfway, but on a personal standpoint, just happy that I could come and do the role that the team wanted with a degree of success.
The Guyana Amazon Warriors have been looking like the team to beat. How do you assess your team's performance out there in this first innings?
I think it's a very good job. If you look up and down their batting lineup, it's probably one of the more complete lineups with persons doing roles that are suited to. So for us to come out there and put in that performance, I think it's just about par. It's not as tacky a wicket as we initially thought. So hopefully we can put our heads down and get the total.
How challenging for the team when those fielding restrictions, the penalties come into play?
Yeah, it's quite challenging because I think batters waste a lot of time in the power play, in that first 10, and then the bowling unit pays for it in the back end. And I was trying to tell the umpires on the power play, just keep watching the time, just keep watching the minutes, because we can pay for it. And obviously in the back end, we had to field with two fielders out. So it's probably something that the umpires need to have a look at from the beginning of the game, not just the middle and back end phase of it.
Carlos, a decent score on the board from the Amazon Warriors, but we saw the last ball of the innings. They ran four. I'm not sure I've seen that this season. Does it give them a bit of momentum going into the break?
Not really. I think on us, it's more sloppy, and us probably being a little bit disappointed with ourselves with how we let the four happen. But I think credit to Jace bowling the last over with two men out and executing the way that he did. I think we're happy with that.
Confident with this run, Chase?
Yeah, we should be. Once we bat well, we should go close and hopefully we could go over the line.
Well bowled. Thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Oh, I don't care what anyone says. Great to have him back in the CPL. That's for me. 182 required from the 20 overs. The asking rate is steep. It's just over 9 from the start in the bright sunshine. Short break, and we have more for you on the other side. Don't go away. Sai Mayub was outstanding once again, particularly as he got out of that power play, back-to-back half centuries for him. Shea Hope shepherded him for most of that knock and got his 50 as well. 23 of 10 to Kimo Paul, 24 of 16 to Shimron Hetmyer, 181 for 9, the Amazon Warriors off their 20 overs.
We love a lefty. 58 from 35. This time, Ayub, including six sixes and 1-4. Favored the offside, the onside. But made it look really easy once he got out of that power play. Yeah, that partnership, 98 from 64 between Ayub and Hope. Brilliant stuff. Good foundation. Yeah, then it was Shea Hope with his 50 from 40. Four sixes and 1-4 included. Really good to see him back-to-back 50s in the runs.
Braithwaite, very, very good given the carnage that ensued in the middle overs. 4 for 27, 2 for 25 for McCoy. Good to see him get a little confidence builder and hold a very steady with 2 for 37. Expensive in his first game, two games ago, left out of the previous game, and Braithwaite back with a bang.
Yeah, I love the change of pace in the deliveries, the faster ones, which picked up at least two of his wickets. Then the line in the final phase with fielders, only two fielders out. Yeah, has to top that most fantasy points. That dream 11 stands clear with 138. Next in line is Saib Ayub with 87. Obe McCoy, Shea Hope, Jason Holder, just to finish off that list.
So 182 required from 20 overs for the Royals. Again, they'll have to go some. The Amazon Warriors, a well-rounded bowling attack. We'll take a break and come back with more.
Welcome back to this run, Chase. The final day of action in this leg of the Republic Bank CPL. Rakim Cornwall opening the batting once again for the Royals. Had that century a few games ago at the Kensington Oval. Just four after that. At the Queen's Park Oval alongside him, Kyle Mayers. How good was he last time around? 70 from 45. They'll need these two to click together. They haven't done so with regularity this season. Can they buck that trend like they did with the ball? The final phase today, they were really good. 40 for 6 is what they picked up. Fabulous Royals. Dwayne Pretorius given responsibility with the new ball for the Guyana Amazon Warriors. This will be the highest successful run chase at this venue in the CPL if the Barbados Royals manage to get there. Highest successful run chase at the moment, 169 by the Guyana Amazon Warriors against the Jamaica Tallowers in 2017. First ball off the run chase. Huge shot from Pretorius. The umpire isn't interested. Yeah, Pretorius is keen. What a start, Darren Ganga.
Yeah, an eventful one. I don't think this would go on to make contact with the stumps, judging from where Rakim Cornwall planted that front foot. Appears as though that ball was sliding down the leg side. Of course, we will have the chance to review and confirmation that it was a legal delivery. Front foot on leg stump and ball sliding way down. So we'll wait and see. I think Guyana will be disappointed with this decision to go for the review.
Yeah, just waiting on ball tracking. That's confirmation then of that decision. Impact outside the line, so no need to go any further than that. Decision upheld by the umpire Chris Wright. So eventful start, but not a successful start for the Amazon Warriors. Crunch straight back over his head. Kimo Paul is quick. Very quick. Only one. Off the mark, Cornwall. Off the mark, the Royals.
And the opposite could be said of Rakim Cornwall between the stumps. Just a single. I guess that's the compromise for the power from this man. Just a firm push. You have to admire Rakim Cornwall and his stroke play. It's not one-dimensional. Can hit the ball powerfully straight down the ground to leg, over cover as well. That requires a lot of skill. Mayers on strike.
Yeah, it will be a boundary. Might just be leg buys. Yes, it is. A little bit wayward from Pretorius.
You can understand what he's trying to do to Kyle Mayers. Mayers slightly more powerful through the offside. So he's trying to maintain a very straight line. That's too straight.
These two are quite aggressive in the power play. They'll be looking for boundaries. Looking to get their team off the flyer, perhaps trying to capitalize with the new hard ball. They'll be faced with a heavy diet of spin throughout the course of this innings. Gurakesh Moti, Imran Tahir, Junior Sinclair.
Yeah, and what we've seen from the Warriors previous to this game, just four overs of spin in the power play. Will that change? Majority of the spinners, they bowl in that middle phase of the innings. 28 overs so far.
Another huge appeal. He thinks it's pad first. The umpire doesn't agree. Or perhaps he thinks so too, but it's not out. Either way, will Imran Tahir go again? Already unsuccessful in the over. It's too late now anyway, isn't it?
Was he scarred with that previous decision and the advice given? Hint of inward movement from Pretorius. Height surely in question.
Yeah, sort of rushed Calmiers there. There was a little bit of movement towards the bowler. Good start from Pretorius. Really good line to Calmiers. One gone, five without loss.
Guyana Amazon Warriors, they were very good through the middle phase of the innings. 92 runs scored at a good tick of 10.2. Got them to 181 for 9.
Can the Barbados Royals continue their trend this season? They've won, they've lost, they've won, they've lost. The last game they've lost, so by the historical evidence, they're due for a win today, but they're up against this team for the first time this season. IBW shout in the last over, impact in line, and yes, the height, as you mentioned, Darren Granger, was questionable. The decision from the umpire vindicated. Gudakish Moti with his left arm spin. So spin from the Amazon Warriors in the power play quite early. Gudakish Moti has the record now of opening both the bowling and the batting. Much like Kyle Mayers. In the air, just over his head. Clear intentions from Rakeem Cornwall. Saw him dismissed off the left-hand orthodox in the last game. Eludes the fielder this time.
And you can understand why Imran Tahir has opted for Gudakish Moti, already with a 4-4 in this season. 7 wickets to his name and an economy of just over 7. So if he doesn't create wicket-taking opportunities, he will be quite economical in this phase. You restrict boundary scoring, you put more pressure on the Royals in this run chase, you send that required rate higher into double figures, maybe.
Rakeem Cornwall wants the single, sent back by Kyle Mayers. Not often do you see that the big man wants the strike.
He's quite eager, and why not? In good form, yep, he was motoring down and then had to amble back. Rakeem Cornwall. Be good to see that from side on.
Smashed. Absolutely smashed by Kyle Mayers. A Republic Bank maximum.
And that is what confidence does. 70 in the last game. Kyle Mayers now feeling much more sure about his game. Been through some tough times as a batter at the top of the innings for the Royals. Now, making a statement with that first strike.
First 6 off the innings.
Really guileful
from Moti. Slower and pull his length back. Just 76.6 kph from Moti. Visit the Skyfair website for the best betting odds. In the gap. It's very, very strong to the offside, Kyle Mears. Any smidgen of width and he'll capitalize.
Did extremely well, Kyle Mears, on this occasion to give himself room. He was expecting a little bit of turn into him, hence the reason his body weight was going leg side. Still had that balance to get that power through the swing, and he finds the gap. And again, Republic Bank maximum again. Kyle Mears is turning things up here at the Brian Lara Cricket Academy. My goodness, that's an impressive stroke from Kyle Mears. Off the back foot, there's little power on it. And it's a creamery novelty sweet play. Beastly from the left-hander.
Yeah, 17 runs in that over. I just think that they might want to check whether or not it was over, but perhaps it's too late now. Rakim Cornwall gets in on the action. Another Republic Bank maximum.
And that's hitting into the wind. He's so powerful that even the elements can't stop the distance on this. Using the pace, getting the angle right. There is a deep backward square, but he gets it very fine. Uses the pace from Pretorius.
Explosive start from these two. How long can they carry on? That's the question. That's been the question all season.
If you listen to Trevor Penny, the head coach of Barbados Royals, before the start of the day's play, he spoke about the importance of this opening partnership in relation to the success that the Barbados Royals have enjoyed. 3 wins so far this season. And on all occasions, the openers, or one of them, have gone on to score big.
Clean them up. Wicket from Dwayne Pretorius. The Guyana Amazon Warriors strike early. Doesn't get past the power play this time, Rakim Cornwall.
Success for the Warriors. And what it does, it reinforces the value in bowling a straight line. Ball finishing on the stumps. Higher percentage and probability of getting wickets when you use that as a bowler. Success for the Warriors. Not so good for the Royals. Cornwall going for 8, 28 for 1.
Evans, the new batter for the Barbados Royals, hasn't really lit up this season in the CPL. Opportunity to make a significant and meaningful contribution today. They need these 2 points. The Barbados Royals slip in position. A stifled appeal from everyone.
Interesting delivery that got the wicket of Rakim Cornwall. I think he just played on top of it. Ball angling in, going through his defenses. Always a challenge for Rakim Cornwall when you can get the ball to seam in and away from him.
Off the mark, Evans.
He's played some useful innings in this number three position. Hasn't really kicked on for a big half century or even three figures. Has tasted CPL previously. Laurie Evans. Also multi-talented Samuel Badri. He's a scratch golfer. Successful over, comes to an end, seven from it with the wicket, 29 for one. For one, the Barbados Royals, Powell Athanase Holder. Some depth in the middle there. Gunakesh Moti replaced by Romario Shepherd from the northern end. Dot the start. Naomi Cowan is somewhere hovering around. Where are you, Naomi?
I mean, I love that there's a bit of cloud cover because we have the sunlight, but we're not being burnt to a crisp this morning here at the Brian Lara Cricket Stadium. Now, I'm surrounded by not only true cricket fans, but some academics over here. Rashan and Darren are students at UWE. They're from Barbados. First, I have a stats and economics student beside me, and I have a civil engineering student beside me. So I feel a little bit out of my league right now, but what I want to know is, give me a probability, give me your estimate for how you think this match is going to turn out, because the Royals really showed up strongly at the end of the first innings.
Yeah, I say we have about a 60% chance to win the match. We've batting good so far, so I think we're confident that we can go on to win the match.
And I don't mean to put you on the spot, Darren, right? But give me like a, how do you do it in stats? So is it a 60% chance, 5 out of 10? How would you rate the current state of the match?
Well, depending on how we continue to bat, we just hit 4 runs, so that's very good. If we keep this pace, we keep this momentum, I agree with my friend Darren here, a 60-65% chance that Barbados could come out on top.
Okay, finally, and Rashan, send some love to the Royals. What would you say to them if they could hear you right now?
I just say, you know, continue doing good, you know, keep on the pressure and push on.
Push on. Now, Sunil, a true Guyanese fan, will be joining us for the finals.
In Guyana.
What do you expect to feel and witness when we head over to Guyana this week?
Well, when we accept the feel in Guyana, it's pure vibes. It's pure.
Oh, that's a 6. That's a 4. That's a 4.
Yeah, it's pure vibes, pure Guyana. And you know, once you come in Guyana, you can't beat we in Guyana. Because this year, it's not like all the other years. 10 years now, we're reaching semi-final, we're reaching final, and we can't win. So this year, we do a special work. We do a jarry, and we even bring the buck. So this year, it's guaranteed for the finals. So what? We're bringing home the final this year.
So you heard it from Sunil. The Royals are applying some serious pressure right now. Just saw 4. How do you feel about this morning's match?
Yeah, well, this game here, we don't make 180. Runs on the board, it's pressure. It's total pressure. 37, they started a good start, but we have real good spinner, and this wicket at Taruba is a real good spinner.
Oh, wait a second, we have a professional commentator here. Yeah. Well, you know what, I'm going to send you upstairs with Sammy. Real pressure down here, Royals versus Warriors, back to the comms box.
Yeah, really good cricketing knowledge from those fans. Always eager to share that knowledge. 4 overs gone, 38 for one. Reader win predictor, in contrast to the fan, he thinks it's 60% in favor of the Royals. It's 58% in favor of the Guyana Amazon Warriors at this point.
that changes throughout the course of the match. Where will it end? Who will take this one? Another change in bowling. Kimo Paul from the southern end, replacing Pretorius. Good discipline from Dwayne Pretorius to Rakeem Cornwall. Bowling to his field, two deep fielders, leg side. He was relatively straight with his line, trying to pitch wicket to wicket in that tram, taking away the freedom from Rakeem Cornwall and eventually getting his scalp. So good planning and execution by the Warriors. One of the things we've seen with the inclusion of Lance Klusner, head coach of this franchise. So precise when he speaks. Heard Lance Klusner talk about Ghanaian Warriors and their catching efficiency. He's just shifted that focus from fielders. Oftentimes you have fielders who are low on confidence, not wanting to attempt opportunities in the field. His focus is for them to give themselves a chance. Focus on taking the opportunity. Don't worry about the outcome. Not too high, but Kimo Paul doing a similar job to what Pretorius did in terms of the line. Cannot be overstated the importance of bowling that wicket-to-wicket line, particularly in the power play. Not allowing the batters to free their hands or their arms. Try to finish as much as possible on the stumps. If they must score, it must be off a good delivery. Take a risk if you must. Deep backward square, deep mid-wicket for Kimo Paul. Clean them up on the stumps. That straight line works again. Another wicket for the Guyana Amazon Warriors. Now this franchise is really defining itself this season. They were superb with the bat, now with the ball. Again, clear plan to bowl straight to Kyle Mayers. The awareness of his strength as a batter, and bang, hitting the bullseye. And Mayers departing for 16, 39 for 2. Batter for the Barbados Royals, Alec Athanase, had a half century, 76 against the Talawas, his first season in the CPL. This is the reason why he's here. Very good delivery, give himself some room. Mears looking to access the offside, perhaps trying to overhit it, lost his shape, lost his stumps. A really well-oiled unit of the Guyana Amazon Warriors. Is this the season for Warrior Nation?
Just want to go back to my point of their odd cricket, which is a department of the game that we don't often talk about. 93% catching efficiency. They've only missed, what, two catches this season. Taken 27 catches, the Warriors. Still with a few matches in this league stage and looks good for qualifying in that playoff round.
Ah. Another successful over in the Sky Fair power play. Five overs gone, 40 for two.
There, not a lot in it. It's a few extra runs and an extra wicket against the Royals in terms of that, but slightly better in terms of the runs scored. But as we can all appreciate, that changes rather dramatically in the course of a few deliveries. Alec Athanase, isn't this Junior Sinclair? Dear Junior. Athanase, I beg your pardon, is facing up. Getting a little excited already. Here's Junior. Going away from the outside edge and inside the power play, there is wide open spaces. So Sinclair treated with a four. And yeah, just flighted and gave himself room. Enjoyed the room from the bowler. Hello, Stacey Ann King.
Hello, Danny Morrison. Yeah, good shot from Athanase to get things going.
Slippers in, and appreciably so, the off-spin on against the lefty. Got away with that one there. Sinclair, he knows it. Just to give himself an uppercut and get with it. Get that flight right, lines and lengths. Still going wide. Sinclair. Oh. And again, offering a bit of room here for Athanase with a creamery novelty sweet play.
Yeah, bowling that wider length, but just too full. Didn't have much to do, young Athanase. Yeah, just through the line of that delivery. His second boundary.
He decided to change tat and come right arm over. And Athanase says, look, I'm going to have a piece of you through mid-wicket now. Get a couple more because this is the last over, the Sky Fair power play. 50 up now for the Royals. Almost had the power play done and dusted.
It has a really good strike rate as well versus spin 56.
Again, how did he get a maxi? Oh, not quite. Probably about half a meter short to finish the power play, and it's 54 for two here.
Yep. Ghana Amazon Warriors were 41 for one. Barbados Royals 54 for two. After the Sky Fair power play.
Yeah, they needed that. They really did in terms of that over going for 14. Confirmation at the end of the Sky Fair power play. And it's time for the captain, Imran Tahir, with these leggies. Laurie Evans has got a bit of a chore on to take him on and rotate the strike. Now the left-handed Athanase to face up. Yes, this is good going in terms of, yeah, lose the openers. But they're ahead of where the Warriors were, as we showed you.
Yeah, current run rate 8.92, required 9.18, so not very far off. And 127 needed from 83.
Touch player, I do like Athanae. He's one of these young stars coming through the ranks. He's also hitting with the breeze on that leg side, being the left-hander against Tahir. Bold skip. Zippy through. It's great top spinners and googlies. Doesn't spin the leg break that much, but yeah, trying the other one.
Yeah, it's good as well from Athanae to just have a look, see these deliveries a bit longer. They're coming through and wrong this time. Imran Tahir.
Bella Junior.
Yeah, no stress at all for Athanae because he's 15 from 10, so, and he knows that he can make up.
Now, as you say, is he bowling? He's going to check this. Athanae's little bamboozle. It's a beautiful bit of flight from Imran Tahir here. I think he gets a bit excited. The bails just came off from Azim Khan. I think the bowler and the keeper just trying to have Athanae's on here.
Oh.
Nathan Butler. Television up. Just checking out. Just going through this. He's looking for a stumping here, was Azim Khan. Tunai's got to go through that ultra edge. He's clearly missed this. A little bit of daylight between bat and ball. Yeah, just a little bit too slow with the gather there, Azim Khan. So Athanae survives.
Yeah, usually you find batters, well, not out is the decision, confirmation.
Only one.
Yeah, usually you find batters losing their balance with those types of deliveries. So good on Athanae.
Yeah, we've had seven, just two from that. 56 for two here, the Royals.
Again, Amazon Warriors winning the toss and having a batter scored 181 for 9 in their 20. Barbados Royals, they need 126 from 78.
Yeah, Sinclair replaced. It's over there, went for 14. So now we're going to have Gurukesh Mukti rotate the strike again. Well, out and about in the crowd, Naomi Cowan.
Danny, we're still on the conversation of generational blessings from the sport of cricket. I'm actually sitting with, oh my goodness, the best group today. Students as well as the coaches from the Darren Ganga Cricket Foundation. No, it's just such an incredible initiative that Darren has started, because kids start from the age of 4 all the way up to 16. Sitting with head coach of the elite performers, Mahadeo Budu, also a former West Indian and Trinidad and Tobago cricket player. Tell me about what we're experiencing here and what these kids have been going through this year.
Yeah, you could see the kids are here enjoying themselves, but we also started, this is the group that we normally take in at 4, the age 16, 17, but we also have a group that, a high performance group that started in January, and those kids, we work in to develop their skills in all areas of the cricket, bowling, batting, fielding, as well as physical fitness, the mental side of the game, as well as analysts, video analysis. And we also arrange games against other academies to play.
Right, because you actually just came from a tour in St. Lucia, which is such great exposure for these kids.
Yeah, definitely. They're getting that exposure and experience. And I myself, as a former player, is passing on that knowledge and experience that I had. We also trying to guide them along that although they've seen the stars here playing, it takes a lot of hard work, discipline, commitment, and dedication to the sport to get to that level.
Absolutely. And we all know the importance of sport with youth development, the development of your mind. And I have to have a conversation with some of our young players. So Preston is new to the academy. How old are you, Preston?
I am 8 years old.
And Preston, you have a birthday coming up, but you've been playing cricket with the academy for about how long?
3 months.
Okay, so tell me about your experience. Tell me about the skill sets you're working on.
Well, we are working on fielding, batting, bowling, wicketkeeping. But my favorite part is bowling. I love spin bowling because it's the best choice to choose, and not fast bowling, because if you fast bowl, you can make the other team can make more run. And spin bowling, you can out the players faster. So that's the best choice I will choose.
Wow, so you're actually quite analytical in how he plays. I love that. Thank you, Preston. Matthias is one of the elite players. You just came from St. Lucia. How did it feel being out there? You left home to play cricket. That must have been such a proud moment.
Well, it was my second tour at the academy. And being away from the country playing cricket away is obviously a great experience. And I thought that the tour gave me a lot of experience to play in another country, to experience the different conditions and the different level of cricket having the Caribbean. And I saw some really good talent, especially in the bowling across there, which even gave me challenges while I was batting. But I really enjoyed it, and I thought that it was a great exposure for me and the rest of the players.
That's awesome. And so who are you supporting today on the field?
Guyana.
Why is that?
Because, well, I was a TKR fan, but this year I looked at Guyana and I said, that's the team. That team just came out strong and looked well in my eyes.
All right, well, thank you so much. Thank you, Preston. And this is one of our youngest players. Reina is only 5 years old. She just started. Darren, this is such great work that you're doing. Sammy's doing great work. I just love to see the blessings that are flowing from your careers. And a little birdie told me that Stacey King might be doing the same in the near future. Back to you in the comms box.
Just seen Laurie Evans come down the track here at Imran Tahir here and collect one rather sweetly. Back over the bowler's head for the full quota.
Yeah, I like the fact that he covered that off stump line.
Yeah, Emmy didn't like that. Bosh back over his head for six. Evans, to be aware. Brilliant. They really are sharp in the field, are the Warriors. They're catching. We gave you the percentages. They've dropped the fewest. The least amount of catch has been shelled by the Guyana Amazon Warriors. And now that sort of bit of fielding just lifts the whole unit. Two to go in the ninth.
Catch it!
Well, it's a catcher, but it's a little skimmer. Is that Kimo Paul down there?
If Kimo Paul can't get there, then no one else can get there. Really been quick and sharp on the field.
You get those young speedsters out there, don't you? Fabian Allen. Oh, a little miscue. Lozier Evans gets away with it. 10 off the ninth. Royals, 76 for two. Royals openers didn't really get out of first gear. Mia's hit a couple of sixes, to be fair. Smoked a couple and a boundary. now Evans in this partnership, 37 from 27. Evans striking at, well, let's call it 139. Those three fours and a six. And Alec Athanase, he's striking at 117. He's at 3-4. So just like to up the tempo just a little bit. Nothing outrageous. Angus Dora, chill, refreshing moment winner. 200 US. And you need that product in the heat. Getting on it. Having a ball on a little Sunday afternoon here. On the south side of Trini.
And three matches scheduled for today. So another long one here, Danny Morrison. You need those Angostura chills.
A little bit laced with the ice.
Yeah, yeah.
Again, just dealing in singles, so Moti, they'll be aware of his exploits and how good he is, and breeze coming across that eastern side, so he'll like that. Just a bit of drift, subtle bit of dip possibly on the ball. Use of the feet. Now, Alec Athanase, is looking all right.
Yeah, not trying to hit too hard. Knows that that's the bigger side of the boundaries, and there are fielders out there. Just a little flick of the wrist.
Flick of the wrist there from Losser Evans. Goes for the full Monty again and gets it. Here's his second sixer.
Yeah, partnership runs away to 47 from 32, going with the wind. 91 meters.
Yeah, good strike. It's wanting the ball, and Evans is saying, get that ball back. I want that ball because it goes off my bat nicely. Marius, get up there. What are you doing? Your skates on, Chief. Ball hunter, South African. Yeah, good over this. 10 from it, one to go. Still asking, is it? No, he goes, look, yeah, Marius, could you go and get that? Lozier Evans wants that ball that he just smashed into the terraces up there.
Sure, one of our camera guys followed it.
On the charge, it sounded good, and the timing is as well, but protection out there with Odin Smith. Oh, back up, gentlemen, they are. Yeah, save some runs out there. Well, we've had 10 overs, and it's time for the Angostura chill break with the Royals, 87 for two.
87 for two, the Barbados Royals in pursuit of that 182 to try to win this contest. Two wickets have fallen.
Yeah, Rakim Kwangwal cleaned up by Pretorius, nice and straight. And then Carl Mears follows suit, poles everywhere. Kimo Powell, the successful bowler then. This is the bowling efforts so far. Six bowlers used by Imran Tahir. Two successful. Moti a little bit expensive. 181 for nine is what the Amazon Warriors got, opting to bat first. 58 from Ayub. Half century for Shea Hope as well. 87 for two. 95 from 60. It's setting up to be a really nice end to this game. A really nice part of the world. Trinidad and Tobago, the Moko Jumbies, multi-ethnic, multi-religious, a real rainbow nation, the Steel Pan, Carnival, Calypso, so many things on offer. One of the greatest shows on earth. And of course, if you're into nature, ecotourism, the flora and the fauna, we have that for you as well. Zip lining on the river, the leatherback turtles, limbo. So many opportunities in this wonderful Twin Island Republic. Here in a wonderful venue, the Brannagh Cricket Academy. Most fantasy points, Dream 11, after the 10th over in the second innings. Carlos Brass with 138. He's the top of the list. Saim Ayub, Kimo Powell, Hope and McCoy round off the top five.
Dane Smith, who bowled very well in the previous game, belatedly into the attack. Looking at his leg side field with four deep fielders, will he go straight and into the pit sometimes? Yep. Length, and he perhaps would go shorter as well with that leg side field.
Yeah, he was good the other night at the Queen's Park Oval. Wicket off Andre Russell, had to be reviewed. And then the wicket here off Terence Hines. Also got sitting around, so he's been good in spurts throughout the course of his career. Odin Smith with the ball just needs to find a greater level of consistency. Very talented, no doubt. Smacks it a long way. Broad shoulders, burly young man. But it's with the ball that he's been pretty expensive at times.
The partnership comes up from just 35 deliveries, a good platform. Of course, you've got players like Rothman Powell available to come. Jason Holder, Carlos Brathwaite, Justin Graves in for this game. Six of them into the wind. It doesn't matter for Laurie Evans. A Republic Bank maximum. And that's part of why he's got four deep fielders leg side. He's trying to get them to hit into that wind from back of a length.
Yeah, slow ball, well picked by Evans. Had to delay his stroke slightly to get that connection. And what a strike it was, 84 meters. Laurie Evans has threatened to play a match-winning innings in previous games. 40 from just 24 deliveries he's striking at. Needs to carry on for a little bit more, at least.
Omega XL Skycam, and down the backdrop top left of your screen, San Fernando Hill, down the city of San Fernando. Omega XL Skycam. Back of a length with pace on four runs. These are important runs here for the Royals in trying to make this push.
Yeah, fortuitous from Laurie Evans, went hard at that one, bottom edge. And flew past Azam Khan, not much he could do with that one. Yeah, disappointment for the bowler. Expensive, 12 from it, one delivery left.
Smith will do the work himself, and he takes it. And once again into the pitch, whether it's pace on or pace off, trying to get them to hit into the wind. Top edge and success for Smith.
Yeah, an El Dorado celebration as well from Odin Smith. He gets the reward. Slower delivery into the surface. Laurie Evans threw the shot too quickly, perhaps. Yes, he was outfoxed by Odin Smith. Eyes on the prize, makes no mistake. Another good innings from Evans, couldn't carry on. 44 from 27, 99 for three, the Royals.
Royals captain makes his appearance, Ruffman Powell, with nine overs remaining, 83 required from 54 balls.
That was the plan from Odin Smith, to bowl straight to the right-hander, force him to hit into the wind. He was struck for a six previously off a similarly slow ball. That time he got the wicket. Tahiri to continue. Hundred comes up for the Royals.
Similar scores, very similar in terms of runs on the board. The Royals, two wickets worse off. But right on target at this point. Warriors, though, were very, very good between over 7 to 15. Fell away a little bit in the last five, where they lost six wickets for, I think, 48. Wrist spin to Powell immediately, skipper to skipper. Just missed the opportunity. Azam Khan missed it, fluffed it. Powell was gone for all money, I thought.
Yeah, how costly will this be? He was just wandering out of his crease. Yorked himself in the end, Ruffman Powell. Overbalanced. An opportunity goes a-begging. Didn't have the ball in his hand. Imran Tahir was just about to celebrate. Short-lived.
Slow that down a little bit. Two is the call. They get the two. Let's look at that again. Love to slow it down just a little bit. I think he might be back, but just. Hey. How far off was Azam Khan? Defeated by a little bit of pace, fumbled. My goodness. The fact that that did not go to the television umpire for me. Stop. One oh four for three. Kevin Sinclair on the field for Shea Hope, who's left the playing surface temporarily. Yep, lost the ball.
Required run rate, just a touch under 10 at the moment for the Barbados Royals. Rovman Powell will understand that and know that he needs to get going. We have a visitor. I wonder if he has a ticket to get into the stadium. So he has to get going almost immediately. So whilst he's getting set, has to rotate the strike to understand conditions. He's a boundary hitter of some repute. Imran Tahir still has an over left up his sleeve. That's a good matchup for him. How does Powell play this? Alec Athanase is well set, change in field. Fine leg goes back, mid-wicket, short mid-wicket comes in.
Nice touch from Rothman. Touch to full as well from Shepherd.
Yeah, this is class from Rovman Powell. Just times it to perfection. Moment it beats the inner ring, this outfield gives you value for runs along the ground. Does Shepherd pull his length back now?
FedEx fastest delivery of the match. What did the speech merchants say? Or said, Obed McCoy, 138. Mario Shepherd on there as well. Not as quick as when O'Shane Thomas is around. Or Alzari Joseph. It's interestingly poised, this game. ...71 required from 44. Some teams will say we need a couple of decent overs in our run chase if we are to try to get over the line. Another strategy would be to say how many do we want to get off the last five when that begins with wickets in hand. Do we want to match the opposition at similar stages of the innings? Different strategies. of the good things that Athanase is doing is looking for that single in partnership, first with Laurie Evans, now with Powell, in addition to boundaries.
Yeah, a young man who's made his test debut quite recently, made his ODI debut as well, impressed quite a lot of people. Now he T20 debut season CPL.
Has he hit enough of it? Brilliantly taken by Kimo Paul. He had to be mindful of the boundary rope as he was pedaling to his left and back. Outstanding catching once again for the Warriors.
We've seen some really fantastic fielding throughout the course of this CPL. We saw that stunner from Fabian Allen last night. This one was pretty spectacular as well. The judgment, good hands from Kimo Paul, very, very good fielder. We've had quite a few this season. Alec Athanase goes for 27, 112 for four.
Jason Holder replaces Alec Athanase. Brave from Shepherd bowling the short ball. You could hit with the wind. Very good catch.
Yeah, very close to the boundary, so had to be cognizant of that. Had to keep his eyes on the ball as well. So it's never easy down there. Don't underestimate how difficult this catch is. Another KP, Kimo Paul. Rahman Powell against spin. What are his numbers? Strikes at just a run a ball against spin, all spinners. Against fast bowlers, 150. And against wrist spin in particular, he's been dismissed quite a number of times. 14 runs. The last 14 balls with two wickets. So the Guyana Amazon Warriors are coming back strongly in this contest.
This is Imran Tahir's last over. None for 19 so far. So if the Royals are to fly high today, Caribbean Airlines, a good vehicle to do that. Check out Caribbean Airlines social media for the chance to win tickets to attend Republic Bank CPL matches.
It seems as though Rahman Powell is just intent to see him out. And I suppose that will be the smart thing to do. And just a couple deliveries left. He's off strike now. And Jason Holder might be similarly minded. Quicker delivery from Tahir. Keep him wicketless. More often than not, you have a better chance of winning a contest. One delivery from Tahir.
Yeah, boy, yeah, boy.
And then they can take on the others.
Good four of a spell, economical from Imran Tahir, none for 21. 116 for four. number of options for Imran Tahir as he tries to close out the innings. Pretorius has overs left. Shepherd has a couple. Nordine Smith has only bowled a solitary over. Then a couple of the spinners, if he so chooses. Kima Paul only bowled one over. So Shepherd was originally with the ball in hand. Imran has said, nah, we'll go with Odin Smith. First over from Odin Smith into the pitch. Back of that length, whether it was a cutter or whether it was pace on, just short of a good length. Couple of boundaries and then that top edge. So smart bowling with four fielders deep back on the leg side boundary and into the wind. Only three back on the leg side for Ruvman Powell. Just enough, but you could see the plan again from Odin Smith. Got it high enough, asking Powell to hit into that wind. Yeah, Hetmeyer applauds. Didn't work, but it was close.
Yeah, he was in the reckoning for a bit, but too much power from Powell. I don't think he hit it anywhere near the middle, but still goes all the way for six. Backpedaling Hetmeyer. Yeah, enough on it. We saw Odin Smith being hit for six in the previous over, then got the wicket. Can history repeat itself? Ruvman Powell will no doubt know what's coming or anticipate what's coming. Will it be pace off this time, though?
Two Sinclairs on the field, Junior Sinclair and Kevin Sinclair, both very, very good fielders. Junior actually playing in the 11. That's Kevin, who's on as a sub for Shea Hope. First time you're seeing Jason Holder go and get himself in a few problems with that pull and hook, if you can get it over the right shoulder and high enough. And again, whether it's pace on or off.
Yeah, the face painting, the popcorn, the cotton candy, the free giveaways, the paraphernalia for the young kids in today. Another wonderful day at the cricket for them. Good initiative by the CPL to get them in and to look at their heroes playing. Long off now.
That almost contradicted the field set, because to push the long off back, deep square leg had to come up, and that was almost in that pulling arc where if it had gone past that square leg, it would have been four. So now Imran has a chat with Odin to finish the over. Perhaps get more onto the off stump. Ah, that contradicts the feel. Azam Khan slaps his thigh in frustration, totally contradicting the field. 129 for four.
energy is right time over.
Run chase within touching distance. Run chase within touching distance. Royals, they need a further 53 from 30. Dwayne Pretorius back with the ball for the Warriors. Danny Morrison alongside me. Danny, based on what we've seen from this Royals team, they generally go at 10s in the last five. That's with the exception of that game they played against St. Lucia Kings.
Yeah, and they've got two guns out in the center there with Holder and Tao. Both very experienced gentlemen. And so, yeah, still on the hunt, no doubt. Whilst it is, well, let's call it 11s, the asking rate. Towel has got established, he's in. Holder's only just got out there, had a little bit of a sighter, half a dozen deliveries. And wanting to hit to that onside with the breeze against Pretorius.
Straight to the fielder. That's a soft dismissal, you would say. Shot was on. Jason Holder just couldn't avoid the fielder. Important wicket for the Warriors.
Sure is. That is a big, big breakthrough here for the Warriors. Jason Holder decided to change the angle. Pretorius come around the wicket. And a little flick around the corner. Oh, dear. Plucks out Romario Shepherd, the only guy there on that onside for a long way inside that circle, and he has to depart quickly. Holder for four, and suddenly the Royals are 129 for five now.
Nine-year-old Justin Graves from Barbados strides to the crease. A few butterflies will be fluttering given the situation for Justin Graves. He's here because Danny Morrison, Jason Holder didn't quite get his placement right.
No, like you said, pretty lame in the end. Just a little flick around the corner. Yeah, the bowler just says to Jace, yeah, gotcha, big guy. Thought you'd try and whip me around the park or give me a bit of long handle. But now Greaves with a lot on his plate coming in at number seven.
Cut away, work for that deep point. And he does well. The Bet Barter save by Siam Ayub.
Good stuff. So Graves is underway off the dreaded Duck Dre. Dre Duck. Duck Dre.
Had his best season in his first year, Justin Graves. That was back in 2019 when he scored just over 100 runs, average 33. Since then, he's played in 2020, 2022, now in 2023. So not a lot of matches for him beyond his debut in this Republic Bank CPL. Chance for him to enhance his reputation with the bat.
Yeah, in terms of the death overs for Pretorius, he does like to go wide. He pushes it wide and asks the batter to fetch or have to improvise by going across the crease. That sort of zone there where he does. He gets it either full, he takes pace off. And, Hawke have come up with this in terms of the zones that Pretorius likes to hit in the death overs.
An exceptional over from Pretorius, only four runs coming from it, 133 for five. Match number three shaping up nicely. These two teams in fierce battle for 2 points. Warriors with 181 for nine on the backdrop of two half century from Ayub and Hope. Robman Paul will hope that he can navigate the remaining part of this innings and achieve the high successful run chase at this venue, Danny Morrison.
Yeah, well, let's just say it often is the case, isn't it? The batter happens to be the captain. Powerful character. He's right into it. Republic Bank Player of the Day, and here's KP. Kemo Paul with a beautiful set of hands here. That is stunning. Put that in the vault locker and some crackers here at Lara. Fabian Allen, what a beauty last night. And this from Kemo Paul underlines his athleticism.
From a Warriors perspective, they will want to continue their winning streak, Danny Morrison. Four wins on the trot. Their last game before they go to Guyana at home in front of their home crowd. Second on that Republic Bank leaderboard. Unblemished, you can say, so far in this Republic Bank CPL.
Well, they win and they go to the top of the table. It's as simple as that. He's just trying to tail us in at the toes here is Romario Shepherd. Up against Powley, just doesn't want to give him anything in that length to go over long off, extra cover, square, at all against Robman Powley. So powerful through that offside or back over the bowler's head, let alone if you bang it in, and you won't be doing that on this pitch, Romario. If you bowl short, you are going to go a long way.
Just enough bat. Not the ideal delivery from Romario Shepherd, too full down the leg side. Helping himself, Robman Paul, to another boundary.
Well, they're too wide, so they've only had two legitimate deliveries, and I can understand the ploy here. He wants to go full, but he needs to get it at the base of Midland leg. And two wides, and then this one, well, it's just a freebie. So now he's going to have a chat, and Odin Smith's given a little rev up. Positivity. Hands on hips of Imran Tahir, clapping and getting a little bit vocal now for Romario Shepherd.
Crunched. Sounded really good. Robman Paul getting it off the middle of his bat, and this Republic Bank maximum will help in this run chase.
Ah, Shep, I told you not to. Do not go halfway down the pitch to this guy. Oh, just said, sit me and hit me and hurt me. And it did. Six and some.
Served up on a platter. She hoped, just sharing a word of advice. Udine Smith getting into that discussion. You look at the remaining overs. Smith with two remaining from his four. Dwayne Pretorius, one remaining from his four. More importantly, Romario Shepherd will want to close this over out. Already 12 at the halfway stage of this one. Make that six more. Make that six more, and it's humongous. Clean ball striking from the Royals captain.
We're loving it as well up here, young man. The vibe is starting to get a little bit more interesting now. because he's still, I reckon, trying to get it in the hole there, but he's missed his length, Romario Shep, and he's disappeared for over 100 metres. Knew it straight away. What a sweet, sweet sound off the willow from Rodman Powell. Can we have our ball back, please? Pressure on the bowler, massively. Two wides, 466. 150 out with a biggie from Rovers.
Quick single, he has the hustle, direct hit. Junior Sinclair. Does he have his man? Brilliance with the throw. Oh my goodness, exceptional cricket all around. Is this a game changer?
Well, they seem to think so. There's lots of high fives and another El Dorado celebration, you betcha. You're going to have to come all the way back, Rodman Powell, and head back to the dugout. Wow. O-U-T. What a great throw from Junior Sinclair. Wanted to see a cartwheel or two. Get it out, because I've got rid of Powell very dangerously. 3 fours, 3 sixes, 39 off 19. He's out of here, and now the Royals have lost their sixth at 151.
Figure of Carlos Brathwaite gets to the middle. The world knows his ball striking capability. How about this for brilliance in the field?
Took aim, took his time, in fact, lined it up to Junior Sinclair and was dead eye Dick, spot on bullseye. Last ball of the 17th. Man, what a productive and exciting over. Another one here to finish it. So 19 off the 17th, and the Royals are 152 for six now.
What a platform this Republic Bank CPL is for young emergent players. Let's go food, drink, emergent players. Junior Sinclair, one of those Lasco food, drink, emergent players, putting his hand up, single-handedly getting the wicket of Rodman Powell, which is brilliance. Direct hit. It's another one? No. Just short of Junior Sinclair. Busy once more in the outfield.
Yep. Almost. The youth. Oh, not quite carrying, but man, this Warriors side. That's the sixth run out that affected this season. Best of any team. No surprises. The Warriors.
Nice shot, nice stroke, enough power to get four. Runs leaking.
Oh, do not count out the boys in pink and blue. And you've got Brathwaite, who's just come in, searching Yorker. There's that fuller width that we showed you just moments ago from Dwayne Pretorius. He likes to go full and make the batter fetch, particularly the right-handers. He's under the pump now. Oh, protection, but I tell you what, a few metres either side, and that was Fawzi.
It's a reminder that Barbados Royals went on to achieve the third highest successful run chase in the history of the CPL. when they played against that Patriots team back at the Kensington Oval. Finding his range, Carlos Brathwaite.
Now, could he finish things off? Much like he did back in Calcutta in that World Cup final against the English. Get Bish out of his seat again. And that one wood with the range that Carlos Brathwaite has, extraordinary. But now it's Graves back on strike.
Bald in the gap. Bad delivery and punished. Justin Graves is making his presence felt with the bat.
Well, now, given that Graves is in and set, is a dozen off the side with one to go. Brathwaite's joined him. You think about the odds. I'd love to see the predictor, but it should be in the favour now of the Royals. But of course, as we know, crazy things happen in T20.
One of the two changes in this Royals side for this match number 23, Justin Graves. Always a busy player across the different formats at the regional level. Not many opportunities for him in this Royals setup over the years that he's played, but this will open a few eyes. Right, equation 18 from 13. Last ball of the over. Gets a dot. So that will leave Carlos Brathwaite on strike for the next one. 18 gone, 164 for six.
Yeah, a pair of nines to take it out for the Royals. Dozen deliveries to get 18. That last delivery is where Pretorius was trying to find that searching good Yorker length. Missed it a couple of times and got pumped.
The surge coming at the right time. 31 runs for the Royals in the last two overs. Just shifting control in their favor. Can Romario Shepherd seize control once more? Bowling the penultimate. Here he is.
Well, at the pre-game show, in terms of the Warriors ticking a lot of boxes, they've just been a little off colour here this afternoon with their bowling. Fielding's been pretty good, by and large, as we know, but yeah, just been a little off. Searching for different lengths. The spinners, well, Moti, he won't bowl out there, you'd think. He got through three. Junior Sinclair could only get through one. Captain, he's bowled out. Four overs for 21, and you've... this is the last over for Romario Shepherd. Odin Smith has got two up his sleeve, one for 24, but makes for a fascinating little finish here. The Warriors, well, they wanted to go top. They win here, they go top, but they haven't been beaten. See that in the losing column? Big fat zero. They've been the most consistent.
Skewed by Brathwaite. Took the high backlift out, looking for that big shot, but pays off. Just challenge him a little bit more. Warriors fans, a chance for them to go to rario.com. Lots of valuable players featuring in the tournament. You can buy your official CPL player cards. Nails it in Carlos Brathwaite style. That's his first boundary, but an important one in this run chase. Equation now 12 from 8.
And what an important time to get it. Tried to go Yorker to Shepherd. And big Carlos has just gone boom, boom. Over extra. What a ripper. Big Ricky Brathwaite.
And it just shows when you bowl well, it inspires you to better things in the other departments of the game. Picked up 4 for 27 now. Appears as though he's in control of this run chase. Two is the call. And they will get there comfortably in the end. Rathwaite pushing hard.
Yeah, those long legs. I asked him today before the start of play, and he was walking past our fronting position. I said, mate, what, 33? He goes, no, Danny, 35. I said, don't lose that number. Ricky, wow. Amazing how just time flies. He's 35.
Right, what's Romario Shepherd thinking? Two deep fielders offside, three onside. Goes with the Yorker. Clipped away for four. Carlos Brathwaite is doing very well with the bat too. 12 off the over, 176 for six, and only six required.
Remember the name. He's loving it. Smashing it around. Reeling in the ears. Carlos Brathwaite.
More pressure on the Warriors. They've been a little bit inconsistent with their lengths and lines. Quite a few full tosses. Last one swallowed by Carlos Brathwaite.
Yeah, again, if you're off, you only have to be a little bit off. My word, that breeze is in and it can be hit to one side. Oh, hello, Mr. Moti with the final.
That's a boomerang. That's a surprise. First delivery. And it's a dot. Will this be a masterstroke by Imran Tahir to go with Gudakesh Moti? Many of you, I'm sure, might have been thinking Odin Smith for the final over.
Yeah, I don't mind it. Pace off, gutsy. But it is a big boundary straight, 75 metres back towards us in the long on, straight and long off. But, yeah, you don't quite get it right. That breeze can hold it up in the air, all those sorts of things. Big shout, big shout. I think sliding down, but one shot will do it. They have come upstairs.
And why not? With a review in hand. I don't reckon they've gone for the review, Danny Morrison. So third delivery now to Carlos Brathwaite, and he goes for it. Doesn't quite get hold of it into the safe hands of Kimo Paul. Another shift in this game. Could the Warriors pull off their fifth win, or will the Royals secure the highest successful run chase? Wow, gripping.
Sure is. He wanted to finish it right there. He's trying to win the game with that stroke, was Brathwaite. Given the breeze, was taking it that way. Little cameo has to come to an end for Carlos Brathwaite. A dozen from just seven. And it's all the sevens. The Royals, 177 for seven.
Warriors fans surely worried when Carlos Brathwaite rocked back onto the back foot to play that stroke. No problem, says Kimo Paul, completing another catch. And the Warriors looking composed in the circumstances. Very clear plans from Imran Tahir. Challenge now. 5 from 3. Rolof Vandermeer on strike. 3 legal deliveries remaining in this innings. Should be only a single. Kimo Paul is quick across the ground, and he does very well.
Very alert to it, and so they should be. Everyone's amped on the boundary. Now then, Justin Graves. two left, four to get. Does he want to be a hero? Was he going to get one where he wants it? Not if Moti's got anything to say about it.
Is he going to think cover, over cover? Possibly. Misses! What a crucial delivery from Gudakesh Moti. He's earning his paycheck.
Oh, and listen to this crowd, and the horns are going, and the drums are beating to the max. Last ball, match 23.
Slice, shred to the fielder. The Warriors reign supreme once more. It's a fifth win in a tense situation. And what composure from this side. Gudakesh Moti, the hero in the circumstances. And the Royals, they don't sign the Royal Charter on this occasion.
No, they don't. And the men from Guyana, the Amazon Warriors, in a circle of love. They hung in there. Look at Imran Tahir go. He has revved them right up. Man, that last over, two runs, two wickets, and the wind to nail it by three. Odin Smith takes the final catch and the final moment in this match. Simply outstanding. The belief from this franchise here in 2023 is simply awesome. They are the awesome Amazon Warriors to win by three.
My goodness, what a match we've experienced. Imran Tahir elevated by his coaching staff and brain trust. Collective strength shown by the Guyana Amazon Warriors, and they go on to win once more. Spare thought for the Barbados Royals. The game ebbed and flowed. Balance of power was in the hands of this man, Ruffman Paul, before he was run out. Sheer brilliance from Junior Sinclair.
Just look at these pictures, Darren. He is absolutely gutted because he had the game by the scruff of the neck, 39 and going some, and then got run out, and all of a sudden the Royals chase nosedive. Had a little bit more of Brathwaite until he got out, but a never say die attitude of the Warriors. You think back to yesterday, at Fletcher being the hero on one leg, he got his side, the Patriots, over the line with bat in hand. Today, in the first game, the day game, we've now seen the bowler have his say and win it and be the hero. Simply brilliant. Well, you look at it, that one there of Evans, old Lozza, he's 35 himself. And then you've got Athanase, 27, Powell, 39. That was the key, that run out, that direct hit from Junior Sinclair changed the course of this contest. You had a bit of Justin Graves and Brathwaite try to finish it right near the end in that last over, but was caught by Kemo Paul. And so in the end up losing by three. What a contest.
Well, bowling-wise, the Seamers, they weren't as disciplined as we've seen them in the past. Pretorius with two wickets for just 24. Brilliant. Gudakesh Moti, standout bowler. Of course, defending six runs in the last over. Showing good control, good adjustments, 2 for 38. Shepherd was a little bit expensive. Kemo Paul with a wicket in one over for just two runs. And Imran Tahir, the captain, good economy, always consistent with the ball. Modine Smith was a little bit expensive. No wonder they opted for Moti in the final over. So a wrap on this match number 23. So exhilarating. Warriors 181 for 9 batting first, and the Royals, they got close but not close enough. Warriors going on to win by 3 runs. Dream 11 MVP of this match, Carlos Brathwaite, no wonder at the top. his wicket-taking ability, the way he closed the innings off, 4 for 27. And then that cameo with the bat, 12 off 7, securing the top spot. Kimo Paul rightfully on that list. So to Ayub, Hope and McCoy. If you missed it, Carlos Brathwaite showed glimpses of his very best. The first wicket, that of Ayub. And then Hetmyer going for a big one, held out at backward point. And he kept taking wickets. But Ian Smith couldn't quite get Brathwaite to the boundary. And he finished as a Dream 11 most valuable player. Only 13% of the users voted for him, but he's come up trumps today. Right, let's now go down and join Ian Bishop with the play of the match.
A superb game of Caribbean Premier League, Republic Bank Caribbean Premier League 2023. Congratulations to the Amazon Warriors. Very, very tight. Barbados Royals made a great fist of it. Now the Player of the Match award goes to Saim Ayub for his 58 from just 35 deliveries. Second half century in a row. He receives that check for $1,000. Saim, congratulations, if I may just keep you just this way. And what is it that you've found this way a little bit, sorry if you come this way, in these last two games that has obviously allowed you to get these half centuries?
Nothing special. I just always want to follow my process and just believe in what I did in my practice and just keep the simple mind, keep calm, and always understand the situation and conditions and give your 100%. That's it.
Yeah, it's noticeable today as well as the previous one that the power play strike rate was just about a runner ball, just a touch below, but the middle overs worked very, very well for you.
Yes, because is that kind of pitch you have to get set first, and it doesn't matter in the start of innings if you play slow, because they bowl well in the power play, no doubt. And yeah, if you get set, you can turn that over.
How much are you enjoying this journey here in the Republic Bank CPL?
Yeah, I'm enjoying around the Caribbean environment. These people are so friendly and enjoying the environment. And it's just the spirit of our team, environment of our team. And also one thing more that I want to hand over this man of the match to our bowler Moti, who defended 6 runs in the last over.
All right, that's a great gesture. Gudakish Moti is being given the man of the match prize from Saim Ayub because of what he did in that final over. Congratulations to Saim. Congratulations to Gudakish. Gudakish, thank you very much. All the very best to you. Thank you very much for your time. And I'm sure, what's your appreciation before you go of that gesture?
I want to say thanks to Ayub. And it was a pretty exciting game. We enjoy it.
What did you do well in the last over that brought you success?
The pitch wasn't offering much to spinners, so from the last over, the first couple of balls, I tried to bowl it into the pitch, and which was holding up a bit. And for the last two, I saw him batting outside leg stump, so I was just aiming for the wide line.
And you did it very well. Congratulations to you and the team.
Thank you.
Brilliant camaraderie and teamwork there from the Warriors players. A look at the Republic Bank leaderboard. Warriors with their fifth consecutive win this season. They move at the top, taking over the Knight Riders. Joint points though, but healthy net run rate. Barbados Royals, they remain at number four, and their situation becomes a little more desperate. Work for the Patriots and the Tallowers as well. Right, we're gonna take a nice break, and when we come back, we'll have the captains for you. flame. The winning moment for the Warriors, it was Gurakesh Moti, the star with the ball. And the catch completed by Odin Smith that secured a three-run win for the Warriors, winning their fifth consecutive win. Let's now go down and join Ian Bishop.
Yeah, so often in sport where there is joy, there's often heartbreak on the other side. Ruffman Powell, the captain of the Royals, is here with me, and I could hear Ruffman sighing and head down as for the last minute and a half. Ruffman, commiserations. As you revisit maybe that last over bowl by Gurakesh Moti with six to get, is there another philosophy or a different way that you would say that could have been approached?
I think it was simple. You know, once you get one off the first two or three balls, the game is yours. You know, but those things do happen. You know, we just have to try to be better as a team.
From a bowling perspective, having restricted Ghana to just over 180, given this power play and the middle overs and the end, what were your thoughts?
At the halfway mark, I tell the guys that the Guyana are 10, 15 run short. You know, I think it was it is a pretty decent wicket. You know, it didn't spin a lot, and I realized that once we were bowling, you know, they attack our spinners. So it was evident that their spinners probably wouldn't have bowled.